Hey, this is BE8Z. 212. MSTC, this is BE8Z on 212.
Go ahead.
I'd like to pull a press to test at this time.
Roger, go. Houston flight MSTC 212. Flight MSTC 212.
MSTC Houston network here on 212.
Okay, do we have any data for MGNS for biasing the clock for the CMC clock align, which will come up at approximately 0600 in the morning?
We don't have it as yet. The flight director should be in about 30 minutes or so with his flight control team. So we don't have that information as yet. We'll have him come to you as soon as he gets in.
Roger, if you would have him contact me on 212.
Roger, will do.
Thank you. MSTC, KSTC on 212. Go ahead, KSTC.
Could we have CSGS support on 238, please?
Okay, channel 238.
No problem.
We'll send him over. KSTC MSTC 212.
Yeah, Bob, we should be ready for that plus Z about 5 o'clock.
About 0500.
Yeah, but don't go down until you talk to us again.
Okay, we'll wait till you give us a call.
Okay.
MSTC GMIL 212.
SCS on 212.
Roger.
GNS 212.
Roger.
CDR 212.
Roger, CDR.
C4FC 212.
MGNI on 212.
COSW 212.
Roger.
CUCR 212.
CUSP 212.
Roger, CUSP, CUCR, CUSW, and C4FC, you verify you're ready for the attitude command checks.
CUSP verifies.
CUSP verifies.
CUSW verifies.
C4FC ready.
Roger, CUSW, would you issue IU octal 031?
I copy, IU octal 031.
CDR, STC.
Go ahead.
On the mark, 031, mark.
Okay, CDR, get your LV guidance switch to CMC.
Second.
Your LV guidance switch to CMC. Should be up.
That's a panel 2.
That's a panel 2, call out.
Roger, stand by them, he's in center. Okay, lost vehicle guidance, CMC now.
Okay, MDNR, you verify the lights.
Verify
that. MDNR?
I'll verify the light.
Roger. CUSP, verify spacecraft control indication on.
CUSP, verifies.
Okay, CDR, arm rope controller 2.
Roger, you're breaking up to me, Bob.
Roger.
It's arm.
Coming through any better now?
Roger.
Okay, CUSP, S4B, coast mode switched on.
Coast mode on.
CDR, on road controller 2, give me a plus roll soft stop.
Roger.
CUCR and C4FC, verify 1-4 and 3-2 apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
CDR, give us a minus roll soft stop.
Roger.
CUCR and C4FC verify 1-2 and 3-4 apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
CDR, rope controller 2 to neutral, then to plus pitch soft stop.
Plus pitch.
CUCR and C4FC verify 1 pitch apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
Okay, CDR, minus pitch soft stop.
Minus pitch.
CUCR and C4FC verify 3 pitch apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
Okay, CDR, road controller 2 to neutral, then a plus yaw soft.
Plus yaw.
CUCR and C4FC verify 1-2 and 3-2 apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
Okay, CDR to minus yaw soft stop.
Minus yaw.
And CUCR and C4FC verify your 1-4 and 3-4 apps firing.
CUCR verifies.
C4FC verifies.
Okay, CDR, road controller 2 to neutral and locked.
Roger, completed.
CUSW, issue IU octal 051.
I copy octal 051. On my mark, 3-2 on the mark.
Roger, CUSB, verify your spacecraft control indication off.
CUSB verifies and coast mode switch off now.
Roger, CDR, LV guidance switch to IU.
Roger, LV guidance IU now.
CUSB, CUCR, CUSW, and C4FC completes the test. You can return to your channels.
CUSB, will go.
Okay, all spacecraft channels or stations return to channel 222.
Roger.
testing, 1-2-3-4-5-5-4-3-2-1.
MSTC, CUFE, channel 212.
Who's calling MSTC?
This is CUFE, IU flight control.
Roger, go ahead.
What would be the possibility of having you issue us another plus roll hand controller command?
Okay, do you want to rerun the entire test?
Negative. We'd like to get you set up, go through getting the IU ICO 031 issued, and the LV guidance switch to CMC, and then issuing us a plus roll command, holding it in for about 15 seconds.
Okay, what's the problem?
We saw a spike on when the plus roll command was in on the other run. We saw a spike which didn't look too normal. We would like to have that command put back in and held for about 15 seconds, see if it repeats.
Okay, just plus roll
right.
Command, right?
Right.
Okay, we'll take a look into it. Would you stand by on this channel, please?
We'd like to get it within the next 5 minutes if we could, because they're coming up on some other time punches there.
Roger, we're bringing everybody back over.
Okay.
That's MGNS 212.
Roger, MGNS.
CDR on 212.
Okay, CDR.
USW on 212.
MGNI on 212.
Roger.
MQC on 212.
SCS on 212.
Roger. Okay, all stations, it looks like launch vehicle saw a spike on their plus roll soft command. What we'd like to do is get back into the attitude command checks and repeat the plus roll soft command for them. Okay, we have CUSP, CUCR, CUSW, and C4SC back on the station.
CUSP, 212.
CUCR.
C4SC.
CUSW.
Okay, CUSW, would you issue your IU Octal 031?
I copy Octal 031.
And
Alpha Box 321 Box.
CDR on panel 2, your LV guidance switch to CMC.
CMC now.
And MGR, can you verify your lights?
Verify. CSP, verify spacecraft control.
Roger. CDR, arm your root controller 2.
Ablated.
Okay, CUSP, your S4B coast mode switched on.
Coast mode is on.
And CDR, give us a plus roll soft stop.
Plus roll.
Okay, could we have that held in for about 15 to 20 seconds? This is CUSP.
Any problem, SCS?
Control output looks good.
Okay, CUCR and C4SC, can you verify your commands?
CUCR verifies.
C4SC verifies.
Okay, we see any abnormal conditions?
MSTC, CUFB, you can go to the neutral position, and then would you give us a minus roll, please?
Okay, CDR, would you go back to neutral and then give us a minus roll soft?
Okay, you can go back to neutral now.
Okay, CDR, place it back to neutral.
Hey, MSDC, CUFB, could we have one more negative command, please? I'm sorry, one more plus roll.
Okay, you want a plus roll command?
Roger.
Okay, CDR, road controller 2 to plus roll soft stop.
Okay, let's hold that one there for a few seconds. Okay, you can go back to neutral position.
Okay, CDR, back to neutral. Okay, we see any abnormalities on that run?
Negative, everything looks normal on that run. Okay. That satisfies what we wanted to see.
Do we have any explanation for why we got the spike on the first run?
Not at this time, we do not.
Okay, do you have this documented on any piece of paper on your side?
It will be documented.
Okay, when you get some idea of the documentation, would you come back to 212 and feed that over to me?
I will do.
Okay, all spacecraft stations return to channel 222. All launch vehicle stations return to your normal channels.
MSDC, CUSB.
Go ahead, CUSB.
CUFE, rather. Could we back out of this by performing
Roger.
Sequences to issue Octal 51?
Roger. We'll take it up right now. CDR.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Okay, I just want to verify you're still on station.
The STC RHC2 is locked and covered.
Roger, CDR. Okay, CUSW issue IU Octal 051.
CUSW copies. I'm Fox, 321, Fox.
Roger, and CUSP, verify your indication off, and S4P, coast mode switched off.
CUSP verifies both functions.
Okay, CDR on panel 2, your LB guide switched to IU.
IU now.
Okay, all stations return to your normal channels.
Roger, CDR.
MSTC, KSTC on 212.
Go ahead, KSTC.
Hey, Bob, you got a fallback plan over there?
Sure do.
Come for it.
Roger. Flight MSTC 212. Houston, flight MSTC 212. Houston, flight MSTC 212.
MSTC, Houston, flight.
Flight MSTC 212.
Oh, Roger, the people that are here to monitor the clock line and the EMOD are coming up to talk to you in 1 minute.
Roger, we'll have MGNS come over.
MGNS 212.
Roger, MGNS, stand by here. Flight will be up with your data in a few minutes.
MSTC, Houston.
Roger, flight.
Okay, we've got a guy down here who wants to do this clock align on 215. Can you have him meet him there?
That's the firm. We want to do the clock align there. MGNS wanted to get some data for his biasing of the clock.
STT, we'll get it on 215.
Roger, sounds good.
Okay.
MSTC, CUFE, channel 12, 212.
Go ahead, CUFE.
Could you tell me if you have any recorders on the signals that you're sending down to the IU during that spacecraft hand controller check?
That's affirmative. We do have them.
Could you get somebody to take a look at them in the area of the first plus roll command?
Okay, standby one. We'll get SCS up with us.
Okay.
SCS on 212.
Okay, MSCS, we've got CUFE on channel now discussing the problem launch vehicle saw with your plus roll command.
Oh, okay.
You do have recorders that indicate which commands we're sending from the spacecraft, right?
I got the hand controller outputs on the recorders. I don't know about the GNN outputs. Stand by one. I want to get GNN over with us.
STCSS. Go ahead,
STCS. Okay, I just talked with GNN, and they don't have any recorder outputs of their outputs. They did monitor on the CRT, and they didn't notice anything.
Okay, they didn't notice any abnormality.
No.
Okay,
this is UFP, go ahead.
Okay, we have the hand controller outputs on strip charts. Now, I don't believe we noticed any abnormality at all, though.
Okay, what I was more interested in is if you had the actual command being sent down to us. We were also recording that command. We didn't see anything on it, but there's always a possibility we could have gotten something between samples. That's why I was wondering if there was another recorder on that also.
Okay, on the signal that we're sending down to you.
Roger.
STCS.
Go ahead, SCS.
I don't believe there is a recording at all on that. The only thing they have is the GNN measurement, which is on the CRT.
Okay, so we could get a command file printout on it and pick up the data that way.
Roger, I believe so. I guess we should really talk to GNN first, and maybe they know some way.
Okay, yeah.
You want to get them over and talk to us?
Okay, he's busy in the middle of a test right now. CUFP,
go ahead.
Can we get back with you on this in a few minutes?
I would appreciate it if you would. Could you come back to me on channel 123?
Okay, you're on 123. As soon as
right.
We get MGNS free, we'll get back with you and talk about it some more.
Okay, at that time, give me a call on 123 and I'll come back to 212 to talk about it.
Right, you understand.
Thank you.
SCS, go back to 222.
Roger, SCS.
This is UFE, I'm 212.
The UFE, GNS on 212 now.
Just MGNS.
Okay, what we can do for you is we can get a downlink printout on our data and take a look at it and see if we had any spike on that GNN output to you on that plus roll command.
Okay, this would be a strip chart printout that you could get.
Okay,
strip chart recording.
It's a printout from the real-time data.
Hey, Whit.
On our CRTs.
How long was your spike, Whit?
Very short. And time-wise, I can't tell you. It was very short duration, but still, it did have a delay time to it, more than what you would really determine or define as a true spike.
Oh, is it the same flurry as the signal supposed to go?
No. The spike we saw was on the APS relay monitors. We had the spacecraft plus roll command in, okay, and which meant we had engines 1, 4, and 3, 2 full on during the time that our recorders show that command being solid. The APS engines went to the minus roll polarity and then back to the plus roll polarity, and kind of like a spike.
Okay, but our measurements on the attitude errors going into the computer look solid?
The measurement I have there looks solid.
What are those? Those are 10 samples per second, right?
Pardon?
Those are 10 samples per second.
I'm sorry, I didn't copy.
They're sampled at 10 samples per second.
120.
120.
Which is pretty hard to miss if the duration was as long as it appeared to be from the other measurements.
I see the way, with the only data that we can get is a sample of once every 2 seconds, would you believe?
Sample of once every 2 seconds?
Right. And all this is a number of bits that we are outputting to you. It's not the actual analog signal out.
Okay, what I was wondering or hoping was that you would be able to get a strip out of the actual analog signal. If you can only get something that's going to be sampled every 2 seconds, I don't believe that it would hardly be worth it.
I'd have to agree there.
This, again, this would just be, well, it'd be just every 2 second sample, you would only check the level, so therefore, it'd be a case of pure luck to get on something if it was there, which I really don't believe there is anything there.
It'd be pretty difficult here because what the computer calculates the number of bits that spit out or actually picks it up from the table and then puts it in some registers for display and output.
Mm-hmm.
And it has, it's completely divorced from the output except for those are the bits going into a DAC and the signal comes to verify.
Okay, you got nothing on the what's coming out of the DAC that you could get?
That's right.
Okay, based on that then, let's squelch the original request. We'll look into it further up here.
Okay, I see you at the MSDC.
Okay, tell John, thank you.
Are you in fireman 1-1?
Pardon?
Is that fireman 1 that you're in?
I didn't copy.
Are you in fireman 1?
Roger.
See you, FE.
Go ahead.
Okay, might be to get in touch with our NASA project engineer at 8022.
Okay, just let me write that down.
Roger, and have you documented this problem on any piece of paper?
This problem will be documented on TPR I-8-218.
Roger, copy. TPR I-8-218.
Roger.
Okay.
Okay, who should I ask for at 8022, name-wise?
Goldenberg.
D-U-R-K-E?
Goldenberg. G-U-L-D-E-N-B-R-G.
Would you run that spelling by one more time?
G-O-L-D-E-N-B-E-R-G. Goldenberg.
Okay, I got it. I'll give him a call.
Roger.
I'm going back to 123 now.
Roger.
MSTC, KSTC on 212.
Go ahead, KSTC.
Okay, Bob, do you want to get with you here on what we're going to do on that inspection?
Negative.
Okay, we've got three platforms in right now, so y'all are going to go down and have a real good look at it. And we're going to take out all three of them and put one of them back in. And you come down and make a final look from that one.
Okay, which platforms are we talking about?
The 603 plus Z.
All right, I understand.
You give me a go when that inspection's done, Bob.
Okay, can you tell me what we want to put that one platform back in for?
All right, we got to work on our egress platform, and we need one platform for that.
Okay, this isn't normal in this time frame, is it?
Yes.
It is?
Yes.
Okay, when do we pull it finally? I'll be by Queen of Maryland.
Okay.
MSTC, GMIL, 212.
Go ahead, GMIL.
CMC, EMOD, been performed yet?
Stand by. GMIL STC 212.
Go ahead.
Okay, E-memory will come at about T-minus 10 hours. Do you have a copy of our volume 1? If so, we pick it up at sequence 2279. GMIL MSTC 212. GMIL MSTC 212.
GMIL on 212.
GMIL STC, Vincent, your question earlier. They will be doing an e-memory dump in approximately 10 minutes.
Roger, I understand, 10 minutes.
Okay, you want us to have GNS give you a mark on 212?
It'd be good, please.
Roger, we'll notify you when you're ready to start.
Thank you.
SGNS, 212.
GMIL, STC, 212.
GMIL.
Okay, MGNS, I'll give you a mark on the start of this dump.
Roger, thank you.
GMIL, MGNS. GMIL, MGNS, 212.
GMIL.
Are you configured for an e-memory dump at this time?
Affirmative.
Roger. We'll give you a mark. Start dumping. MGNL on a third verb 74.
Verb 74. Affirmative.
Okay, at a time of 10:49:45, you want to insert enter?
Roger.
Call out a mark.
Mark.
Roger, GMIL. GMIL, MGNS 212.
GNS 2 on this GMIL.
Okay, you copy a good dump.
Roger, we're getting. MSTC, GMIL, 212.
Go ahead, GMIL.
Roger, thank you. We got a good EMOD.
Roger.
MSTC. This is B8Z on 212.
Go ahead, B8Z.
Roger, I'd like to pull a press to test at this time.
Roger, go ahead.
Hey, Larry, CBTS calling you on 111.
MSTC, KSTC on 212.
Go ahead.
Hey, Marv, are they going to gimbal the big engines on the S1?
I guess that's what they're doing now. We got a report from, I'm not sure which engines are gimbling. You got a problem?
No, I just wanted, I was going to tell our people they might feel some movement. Are you feeling movement up top side?
Yeah, the SCO was. He was the only one that noted it, though.
No, okay, real good. Thank you.
AFD network on flight director Luke. Computer Soup would like to write a checkpoint and whenever convenient. So would you poll the guys and see what they say?
Yeah.
say again? We're doing the e-memory dump, but it's an offline computer.
Okay. As soon as Booster gets through his thing, we'll do it. Computer Soup AFD on flight director. Computer Soup AFD on flight director.
Go ahead, AFD.
Yeah, we'll be with you on that checkpoint here in about 5 minutes.
Okay, thanks, sir.